Hello friends, in this video we will see if raw data is given, then by using Tallymax method how we can construct frequency distribution table. For this we see information about Tallymax. We use symbol this vertical line as one value, and general way of writing Tallymax is as group or set of 5 lines. The first 4 lines are drawn vertically and each of the 5th line runs diagonally over the previous 4 vertical lines. See here, for value 1 we give 1 vertical line, for value 2 we give 2 vertical lines, for value 3 we give 3 vertical lines, for value 4 we give 4 vertical lines, for value 5 we give 4 vertical lines and one line which is going from these 4 vertical lines. For 6 value, for value 6 we give set of these 5 lines and one extra vertical line. For value 7 we give this set of 5 lines and 2 vertical lines, and for number 8 we give this set of 5 vertical lines and extra 3 vertical line. Like this we can give Tallymax of any value. Then if suppose we are given this type of problem, draw a tally chart for the data given below. Suppose these numbers are given, then in the solution if we have given some numbers, then first we have to arrange these numbers into smallest to largest form, means in the ascending form. Here I have written all these numbers in smallest to largest form. Then first we prepare one discrete distribution of this chart, these values. For this here we have given numbers 1 2 3 4 5 6 and 7. I have written these numbers as it is here, number 1 2 3 4 5 6 and 7. Then we have to give Tallymax. Here number 1 appears 2 times, there I have given 2 vertical lines for number 1. Number 2 appears 4 times, therefore I have given 4 vertical lines for number 2. Similarly here number 3 appears 3 times, therefore I have given 3 vertical lines for number 3. For number 4 I have given 3 vertical lines because number 4 appears 3 times. Similarly number 5 appeared 3 times, and number 6 appear 1 times, and number 7 appears 4 times. Therefore I have given 4 vertical lines for number 7. Therefore corresponding frequencies are here, 2 vertical lines are there for number 1, therefore frequency of number 1 is 2, frequency of number 2 is 4. Like this frequency of number 7 is 4, and sum of these values is 20, that is sum of frequencies 20. This is our discrete distribution, discrete frequency distribution. Similarly, if we have calculate continuous or discontinuous frequency distribution, means in term of class intervals, then for this, similar to previous one, first we have to arrange given distribution into smallest to largest form, given raw data into smallest to largest form. Then see here, first, to construct a frequency table, for this first we consider smallest value. Here smallest value is 1, then largest value which is 7, then difference of these two values 7 minus 1 is 6. If we have given some more numbers and if difference is bigger than this, then also we can follow these steps and we can find difference. Here difference is 6. If we have to divide or we have to construct 3 classes, then we divide 6 by 2. Then we get 3 classes. And for if suppose we want width of class is 2, then we divide this 6 by 3, then we will get width of this class. Here I want 3 classes, that's why here I have divided this 6 by 2, we get 3 classes. So I have taken first class 1 to 3. Then next class we consider 4 year 4 to 6. Then next class 7 to 9. Like this we can calculate discontinuous classes. See here. In this class 1 to 3 here 1 appear 2 times. 2 appears 4 times and number 3 appears 3 times. Therefore total of these numbers is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. 9. Therefore I have taken one set of this 5 and 4 vertical lines. This is equal to 9. I have written here 9. Then here 4 to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 numbers are there in between 4 to 6, including both 4 and 6. Therefore, I have written here one set of these 5 lines and 2 vertical lines. This is equal to 7. And here 7 appeared 4 times. Therefore, I have given 4 vertical lines to this discontinuous class 7 to 9. And corresponding frequency is 4. And if we add these values, here also we will get total 20. So, like this, we can create any discrete or discontinuous distribution from the raw data by using Tallymax. Thank you.